everyone, what's up? Welcome on Section 51. I am Dose Geek and you are watching Section 51. How are you? Welcome. This is my spaceship and I am on the road to the infinite, unlimited space. How do you say in English infinite? Infinite. In French, we say l'espace infini. But in English, infinite space, the vast space. Infinite space. Wow. Infinite space. Yes. Thank you, Miss, for the translation. we are on the journey to the vast space, the infinite space. On Section 51. Welcome. I hope the previous video was a good video. I hope you liked it. And today we have a new subject, still on the UFO, still about UFOs. As you saw in the title, it's a subject about UFOs and UFOs over California, I think. Yes, it was California. So, let's go now. Let's launch the transition. Yes. Where is the transition? It's here. Yes, we are ready. Let's go on the web. Yes. Okay. So we are back on the website International Business Times. Yes, guys, International Business Times with the same writer, with Inigo Monzon, who published a new article on March the 3rd of 2020. And the article is entitled Video Captures Dark UFO Hovering Over Homes in California. As usual, the first video you can see on the top of the article isn't the video of the article. It is just an advertising video. Let's go down. Let's scroll down. And now we are to the key points of this article. I have to admit that the writer Inigo is really good in writing his articles because it's still he has the sense of the hooking people. When I always read that kind of titles, that makes me dream. I want to read the article. He knows how to give me the need to read his article. So when you reach that point, that means that you are a good writer. Even if what you write is wrong, even if it's not the truth, but he has the talent to make us dream or to make us think about the subject. So the key points of this article are firstly that a UFO was spotted in California. Secondly, the UFO hovered steadily over houses. And thirdly, it resembled the UFO that appeared in Jerusalem in 2011. Yes, there was a famous video on the internet about a UFO hovering over Jerusalem, and we had the opportunity of several times of making some fake UFO videos on Section 51 about UFOs over Jerusalem in Israel. Why that idea? Because we thought that it could be a good idea, an interesting idea, to make some fake video about UFO over some some a great city, some over a city which is a big symbol in the religion history. And sometimes you can see in the human history that religion is not really far from UFO or UFOlogy, because in lot of religions you can discover, you can find some references to UFOlogy or to UFO phenomena. Sometimes, or very often, we have the cases of ancient gods who were inspired by UFO phenomena. So, let's start at the beginning. A California resident spotted a strange UFO floating over a neighborhood. According to an expert, the strange object resembles the UFO that appeared in Jerusalem in 2011. Footage of the UFO in California was captured and shared on YouTube by user Judah Fide. According to details of the clip, the strange object was spotted in the city of Porterville in Tulare County, California. The first video captured by Judas Fide was taken from a distance, and it shows a dark and circular object floating over trees and houses. Based on the video, doesn't seem to be moving. And for the second video, Judas Fide started recorded after walking towards the object, which happened about 22 minutes after he took the first video. At first, Judas Fide thought the object was some type of wizard device or a balloon used for advertisement. So I propose you to watch some extract of the video, and you can also go to his YouTube channel Judas Fide to see the complete video, to watch the complete video. So you can see a circular shape, very dark, hovering over the houses and over the trees, and he's moving with his camera, maybe his smartphone, and you can see that the movements of the shape is really is following the movements, the moves of the camera. So that makes me very I don't really know if it's true or fake. If it's fake, again, it's well, very well faked. Because, and as in a lot of YouTube videos, a lot of UFO YouTube videos, after all, this is a UFO, this is an unexplained, an unidentified flying object. However, if it's faked or not, this is a video of an unidentified flying object. We don't really know what it is. And we have to admit that this is a nice video. Very clear, very net, very sharp. And he zoomed. He zoomed back, and the UFO is still there, not moving. That's very stable. So that's a really nice video. Now, so I deduce that this is the first video. Ah, and we have here the second video. Here. At first glance, we should say that it's some kind of balloon. But there is no reflection, it is very, very dark, and there is no... and it's not moving. It's not moving, there is... at least it should move with the wind. That's really strange. And what he's saying? 22 minutes after the first video, I walked closer to the suburbs to see if I could get a closer video of whatever it was. The object floated over the homes of my neighbors and moved a few times, but stayed floating over a few houses. I thought it was a weather balloon at first, but no strings were visible and it didn't move with the wind, as a balloon on a string would. Also, why would a weather balloon or advertisement float over suburban homes? I have no idea what it is. So I invite you to go to visit and check his channel, because he needs some more views, and he needs that his videos to be shown. So very, very interesting. So we watched the first and the second video. However, after getting a closer look, he noticed that there were no strings attached to the object or any other material that would support it. Also, unlike a regular balloon, the mysterious object remained motionless in the air. That's what I was saying. It was really motionless in the air. Whereas, as usual, you always have some wind, even some little wind, some how to say in English. Some airflow, some airstream, and it should be moving with the airstream. The object is saying, here are his own words. The object floated over the homes of my neighbors and moved a few times, but stayed floating over a few houses. Judas Fide stated in the video's description. I thought it was a weather balloon at first, but no strings were visible and it didn't move with the wind, as a balloon on a string would. Also, why would a weather balloon or advertisement float over suburban homes? I have no idea what it is. That's really intriguing. After viewing these videos, Scott Waring of ET Database, this is the UFO expert, noted that the object has distinct features such as rippled surface. Waring noted that it slightly resembled the object that appeared in Jerusalem in 2011. According to reports, the spherical object descended on the dome of the Rock Temple. Then, after a couple of seconds, it suddenly shoots up in the sky. The words are, the object's surface is not smooth, but sun-like with ripples and waves on it. It reminds me of the UFO scene of the Holy of Holies, Dome of Rock Temple in Jerusalem, Waring stated in a blog post. We have a link here. Oh yes, that's the famous video of the UFO over Jerusalem. You see? 2011. And it was going down in the city, in the temple. And it shoots up. Yes, so that was in Tulare County, I don't know how to pronounce it in English, in California. So do we have here in section 51, on section 51, do we have some people from California who were the witnesses of that kind of event? Did you witness this event in California, in Tulare? That would be really interesting to have your reactions, to have your comments, and to collect your witnesses, your testimonies about that very spectacular event in California. You could see the really dark and circular shape of the UFO in the sky, and the video was very, very clear and very sharp, very precise. So that's really intriguing. Sometimes you can see since the beginning that's a fake video, but here in this video there is a lot of questions. Clearly and sincerely, I don't know if it's true or fake. And that's why I like it, because when I don't have any answer, when I don't have the answer, that's interesting. So I think that kind of video will make people discuss during long time. So people, guys, what are your reactions? What are your feelings about that video? Were you witness of that event in California? If so, share your witness, your testimony with us in the comments. Let's share your experience with us in the comments. I'm very curious, and maybe Judas Fide will have the need or would like to come here in the comments to share his experience or experiment with that UFO. Maybe he will be very happy to comment the video here on section 51. So here is we are now at the end of this new video. I hope you liked it. I hope that you learned some new things, that it was very rich in terms of information and in terms of ufology. I am impatient I can't wait to see you in the next video. So stay tuned on section 51. Keep your eyes wide open. Watch the sky, and live long and prosper. And of course, like, share, and subscribe to section 51. This was Dose Geek. See you next time, guys. Stay safe and stay tuned on section 51. Bye.